Dear professional friends, in this video, I am going to discuss about the key takeaways from Companies Amendment Bill 2020 passed by Lok Sabha on 19th September 2020. Lok Sabha passed the Companies Law Amendment Bill on Saturday, which 19th September 2020, which proposed 72 changes to the Companies Act 2013 to decriminalize and reduce or remove penalties of various offences aimed at improving the ease of doing business, as suggested by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Decriminalization of Companies Act. 48 sections have been amended to decriminalize and 17 sections have been amended to improve the ease of doing the business. 23 compoundable offences would be recategorized out of 66 compoundable offences under the Act to be dealt with an in-house adjudicating mechanism. So now this will be dealt in an in-house adjudicating mechanism. Besides, 7 compoundable offences would be omitted. So there will be complete omission of 7 compoundable offences under this amendment. According to government, these 66 offences were minor, technical or procedural defaults and did not involve fraud, injury to public interest or any non-compoundable offences. This would also reduce the burden on the National Company Law Tribunal. 35 serious offences called non-compoundable will include fraud, injury to the public interest or deceit. Corporate social responsibility. Provisions under this amendment bill allowed companies to roll over excess corporate social responsibility CSR spending to succeeding years. Earlier in the there is no provision to carry on the corporate social spending. Now it is allowed to carry on, roll over it, and exempted companies with a CSR obligation below 50 lakhs from the need to set up a CSR committee. So companies with the CSR obligation of rupees 50 lakhs need not set up a CSR committee. This will give a lot of relief to the small companies because they need not appoint independent director or CSR committee. Direct listing in the foreign jurisdiction. Enabling provisions for the direct listing of securities of Indian public companies in permissible foreign jurisdictions. So this will help all the Indian companies who want to list in foreign NASDAQ or London Stock Exchange or any other stock exchange. Change in definition of listed company. Empowering the government in consultation with this SEBI to exempt private companies issuing specified classes of securities on exchanges from the definition of a listed company. Now the private companies who have listed their debentures will also be come under the category of listed company. Now they are going to be exempted. So no more private companies will be called as listed companies, even if they have listed their securities like debentures in the stock exchanges. Remuneration to independent director and NED, non-executive director. Further, the exemption provided to the key managerial post from the government mandated restriction on compensation in case of companies facing liquidation is proposed to be expanded to include independent directors as well. New NCLAT bench, so new appellate tribunal bench will be going to be set up. It also provides for setting up additional benches of National Company Law Appellate Tribunal in locations specified by the central government. New chapter for producer company. To incorporate a new chapter 20XX1A in the Act relating to producer companies, which was earlier part of the Companies Act 1956. Reduced penalty for small companies, OPCs, 1% company and startup companies. To expand the applicability of Section 446B relating to lesser penalties for smaller companies and 1% companies to all provisions of the Act which attract monetary penalties, and also to extend the same benefit to producer companies and the startups. Friends, the new amendment is going to bring lot of changes in the Companies Act, and main of these amendments are decriminalization of Companies Act and corporate changes in corporate social responsibility and direct listing in foreign jurisdiction, change in definition of listed company, remuneration to independent director and non-executive director, and new NCLT bench to be incorporated and new chapter for producer company, and these are all the main changes and amendments which are going to happen. And if the bill is going to be passed in the Rajya Sabha and signed by the president for the act. Thanking friends, thanking for watching this video. If you like this video, I request you to please subscribe my channel. Thanking you once again, R. V. Shekhar, practicing company secretary.